right? Once again, I want to give all praises to Yahweh, Bashem, Yoshai, Bashem, Makakarash, the double answer unto your apostles and the earth of your ministry, for the Afghans will wide, pushing his truth, and the fish shall allow me unto you. This is the word from ETM at Shrinatka. This is the quick edification, the spirit of Musa, Yahweh, Bashem, Yoshai. So, my edification today is just an upliftment to brothers, you know, on personal character. Because, you know, at times, you know, we're in the flesh, so at times we may get emotional about a lot of things as men in the truth of the Most High, Bashem, Yoshai. So, the edification title is entitled to Stop Malice and Wrath, Being an Emotional Brother. So, just to build character for myself, for anyone else who was identified with it. You know? So I'll start off with Sirach chapter 27 and verse 30. It says, Malice and wrath, even these are abominations, and the sinful man shall have them both. But before we go further, let's look up the meaning of malice, look up the meaning of wrath. So, wrath goes back to
Strong's G, 3709, Argay,
which means anger, the natural disposition, temper, character. You go back to that word character again. Movement or agitation of the soul, impulse, desire, any violent emotion, and especially anger. Anger, wrath, indignation. Anger exhibits in punishment, hence used for punishment itself, of punishment inflicted by the magistrate. So, you know, there are times you will encounter brothers, they get angry easily, you know, they get emotional easily. They can only accept yes. If they accept no, they accept it with some sort of disposition or temper. You know, their whole character changes because they just can't have their way at that point in time. And these are things that need to be adjusted, especially in the truth of the Most High, Bashem, Yoshai. And I said it was the truth of the Most High, Bashem, Yoshai, and not the truth of any man. So, whereas any brother, whether be low or high, will have their part to do in the truth, you have to learn to build your character and ensure that it's not being upon wrath. You can't always be emotional at all times. It can't be that if a brother say yes, you're happy with the brother. But if a brother say no, your character start to change towards being temper, being easily agitated, you know, that kind of way? No, it shouldn't be. So let's go back to what malice means.
Strong's G 2549, Kakia.
Right, so it means malignancy, malice, ill will, desire to injure. Ill will means that you're thinking of something bad to happen to a brother, whatever the circumstances may be. In order for you to use that word, you actually want to ask, and you're thinking ill will towards that person, it shouldn't be. Not in the truth of the Most High of Hashem Yishai. That's the spirit you need to get under control. Wickedness. Wickedness that is not ashamed to break laws. Evil trouble. So we understand what the meaning of malice. We understand the meaning of wrath. Yeah? So, go to Ephesians chapter 4. Verse 23. It says, and be renewed in the spirit of your mind. And that, I'll go all the way down to 32. And that he put on a new man, which after Yahweh was created in righteousness and true holiness. Wherefore, putting away lying, speak every man truth to his neighbor, for we are members one of another. And there are times you will encounter brothers who will, they will come and tell you something to see your emotion based upon what they said, so that they can test you, or they can come to a conclusion. But then they came with it in a crafty way. And you brothers need to be careful with that. If you have a matter with a brother, you don't come with a crafty sentence or a crafty word to see that you can point a finger and say, aha, caught him. Look what he said. You know, you try to deal wisely with the brother in your word. You need to be careful with that. Verse 26, but be angry and sin not. Let not the sun go down upon your wrath, neither give place to the devil. Let him that soul steal no more, but rather let him labor, working with his hands, the things which is good, that he may be good to him that needeth. Verse 29. Let no corrupt communication proceed out of your mouth. Yeah, that's corrupt communication I was speaking about earlier. But that which is good to the use of edifying. That is, may minister grace unto the hearers, even your own brothers, Joachim. Verse 30. And grieve not the Holy Spirit of Yahweh, whereby ye are sealed unto the day of redemption. Let all bitterness and wrath and anger and clamor and evil speaking be put away from you with all malice. We went over what malice is, we went over what wrath is. No? So James chapter 1 is 19 to 20. Says, therefore, my beloved brethren, let every man be swift to hear, slow to speak, slow to wrath. Again, what they said. Therefore, my beloved brethren, let every man be swift to hear. Hear and understand what a man is saying. Hear and understand. Slow to speak. And slow to wrath, you know. Just one moment, okay. So, verse 20. For the wrath of man worketh not the righteousness of Yahweh. That is not part of what the Messiah, what the Messiah is looking for, you know. That should change. Never too late. You have a spiritual brother, you go meet him, you go talk to him, or you do the right thing. What is the right thing? Can be wrath, it can be malice gathered up within your soul. But rather, what it should be, you go to Matthew chapter 6, verse 14. It should be, for if you forgive men their trespass, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. But if you forgive not men their trespass, neither will your Father forgive your trespass. And it's simple as that. Let's forgive our brother. And you talk to him about it. It's a little too pressed, and you talk to him about it. And you move on there. Don't guard up malice and wickedness and wrath in your heart towards anyone. And stop being emotional. That's not something you're looking for in the truth of the Most High Abbas and Meshai. Because it's difficult to deal with an emotional brother. Especially when, you know, the brother don't get away, he become emotional. So then, you know, you don't know how to approach this man anymore. It shouldn't be like that. You know, stop. Cut all this emotional shit with men. You know? So with that, I want to give all praises to Yahweh, Bashem, Hashem, Bashem, Matash, Kadash. And double on the empty apostles and the other great soon. We saw them worldwide. And say Shalom be unto you. This is the word from the CMS and the account. Shalom.